Hi guys, how are you going and welcome to Crazy Cracker Plans. You're here for another video and this one I'm quite excited about. It's actually to do with my new cash stuffing envelopes and ideas and things. So I purchased these, one off an Etsy shop. It's called Wild. I'm not exactly sure if that's what the Etsy shop is called or not, but it's an Australian stockist of different things. You would have seen these. It holds all these different areas of cash, money, and it's got little pockets to be able to put like name cards in. So I was just going to use these to a piece of paper for right now to write those categories on them. And then this wallet will come with me. They do also have a bigger version that's about this size in it, that you can put things in, but I'm not using that one. I got this one. So I'll be setting that up, but then I've also got this with all the different labels. So I'll be putting them on and putting it in here. So if you're interested in this process and how to put together one of these, then definitely stay tuned. Okay, so I got the pretty purple one. It's available in like six different colors: green, yellow, pink, blue, purple. I can't remember the other color, but anyway, it's available in a few. And it just comes with the one I got from Labelle Stickers. Comes with 12 different little envelopes, and then it did come with just some sticker label things, which actually I may use in my wallet. Oh, that's a good idea. But they just all go in here. They have little Ziploc little things that just open up, and then you can put your money in there. So I've got all these little labels that I made, or got Labelle Stickers to make for me, that have all these different categories. So I'm just going to be sticking these onto here. I haven't used these heaps, so it may take a bit of practice to make sure I'm doing it right. But these are just all the different categories that I'm using for these. So I'm going to have a go and putting them on. Oh no, wait. I remember. It's meant to be the other way, isn't it? Okay, so the idea of these is to get the black stuck to the sticky backing. So it's helpful if you've got like a card or something. And then, yeah, there you go. So you get it stuck to the sticky. Like that. And then you get your... Am I in frame? I hope I am. Woo! Camera! Sorry about the lighting and the workspace and stuff. I'm just in my mum's lounge room, just trying to make it work on whatever I've got. And I've only really got... Do I want it up there? Or just generally in front, I think. So you stick it on, get your card or whatever it is you're using again, stick it back down as much as you can, and then hopefully it's stuck enough that if you pull this off, it'll stick. Ha 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 ha! That is so cool. That looks really good. Ooh. So I'll stop talking. I'll put some music on because I don't need to chat you through each one, I suppose. So that's haircuts, and you'll get to see each one as I'm doing it, but I'll put a bit of music on and get it to speed up a little bit maybe so it's not too boring, but I'll just get going on all of those.
Love that we'll never need to hide. Love will always rise above. Whatever comes, we will be just fine. If I am yours and you are mine, take my hand and let's fly away to to another galaxy. Hold me close, I want to feel your love. Together we are free. Just be with me. Just be with me. Just be with me. Now we're one with the sun over our heads, and at night we'll be the stars. We can go any place that we want to. I don't care if that's too far. Take my hand and let's fly away to another galaxy. Hold me close, I want to feel your love. Together we are free. Just be with me. Just be with me. Just be with me.
Okay, so sticking this last one on. This one's a bit bent, but that's all right. I'll just unbend it. Last one is Christmas and Easter. There we go. Because I'll start, like I'll save for one, and then we'll use it, and then it'll be saving for the next one. And then just keep it going like that. So there's enough time to save for Easter after Christmas. Usually, so because we don't use too much at Easter time because it's mainly Christmas time. So it'll work for using it for both. Okay, so I've stuck them all on there now. I'm so stoked. They look so good. I think I want savings to go behind though, so I might move that one. All right, I haven't put them in any particular order at the moment. We're just going to put them in. So we've got savings. Oh, going in there. And then school needs, like their school bags and their school books, school clothes, any sort of school needs like that. We've got car rego. Put them in. Because they're new, they've got all these little things on them, so I'll end up having to get all those. Then we got birthdays. So instead of doing them all individually, because that would be a lot of envelopes, I just got birthdays in one, and I know sort of how much I allow for each of the kids and that sort of thing. Then we got medication, we got insurance, and that's like insurance on the car and contents insurance on our items that we own. Car maintenance, so that's like any servicing on the car or any, you know, out-of-pocket things that might have to happen. Activities, and this is just any sort of like fun, different activities that we might want to do, or special sort of things will be that. And then haircuts, because the boys like particular styles now and I can't do them, so we'll get their own done. Then we got annual pass, because where we live in Victoria, we've got Sovereign Hill and the Wildlife Park and Crowell Castle and a few other different things. So saving up for some annual passes because we like to go and do things, though obviously at the moment that's not a possibility, but when it is. And holidays, getting to go away on a holiday, even if it's just going somewhere camping, is something you'll need to save for either way. And then Christmas and Easter. I don't know why this one got bent, but that's right, it'll flatten back out. So put all of these in here, close it back up. It's full now. So at the moment, I don't know if it'll work yet. At the moment, I've got half and half to spread it out, but I think it might be even still too full. So like that. So I would probably sort of drag them across a little bit so they're closing at different intervals instead of being all together. I'd probably do that instead, just so it shuts better. But so this is the general idea, is you have all these different things, and then you're putting basically when you get paid, you've figured out your budget, and you're allowing a certain amount of money to go into as many of these as possible, so that each fortnight or whenever you get paid, you're regularly saving towards these things. And the idea of it keeping it like this is being able to keep track of it a little bit better, because tap and go, I find, can be really dangerous. It's really easy to overspend or buy things you don't need just because you can just tap and you're done. It's very, very easy to do. So I don't want to be constantly doing that. And then in this one, in these ones here, it's going to be, I want to double check before I write them down and stick them in. There's going to be petrol, school lunches, my spending, I think. Anyway, there's the different sections that I've got for in here as well. Groceries, like shopping stuff, and petrol are the two main ones, and like the kids' money and things like that. Ones that I will use every fortnight using it. And then this is like your sinking funds, your stuff that you're putting towards it, and it'll add up, sort of thing. And you won't use this anywhere near as often. So that's about it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's not anything special or anything. It's just a short one, just putting stuff together. But I just wanted to share it with you all because I'm so excited to have this set up now, because I get paid next week, and I really wanted to have it set up so that I could start, as of next week, doing my cash envelopes and doing this system. So I'm hoping, crossing fingers, that I can do a good job of this, and that way I will have these things able to be getting in advance of paying for them, and I think that would be awesome. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this video, guys. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in seeing how I stuff these envelopes and then what I do with that, definitely let me know and I can do some videos on those. If you're doing cash stuffing, let me know. I'm interested. And if you're not, is it something you're interested in trying? I know that nowadays cash isn't always a big thing because of COVID and all that sort of thing. It's less. But yeah, I think this will be a better way to keep track of things. Because I was going to try and open up like a few different bank accounts, and then I'm like, no, that I'm going to have to pay for each one. And then that's keeping track of all these different bank accounts. Whereas doing it this way, when I get a certain amount, I can just generally put it into a savings account and know, you know, what each bit of money is for, because I've got it written down somewhere. So yeah, hope you've liked this, guys. See you in the next video. And while you're waiting, don't forget, keep on planning, guys. See you soon.